I went on the road the first time when I was 14 with Jerry Lee Lewis. That was my first experience with the big time, so to speak. He came over after he'd gotten kicked out of England for marrying his cousin. They didn't like that. And so they kicked him out of the country. He was playing at Kane's Ballroom in Tulsa, is where I was from. They hired my band, me and my band, to be his background band. Well, him being a piano player, I studied all of his stuff and his rhythm section. But I taught my band, because we played all of his songs, and I taught my band how to play what they were playing. Russell Smith always played a kind of a shuffle that was a ska. He'd hit the ride cymbal on the bass, and then he'd hit the afterbeat on the drums. Boom, cha-dun, 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 cha-dun. And Jerry Lee would, on top of that, would play boom, 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 boom. They're actually kind of conflicting parts, but it made a whole lot of shaking going on. So we did all that stuff. You know, he started out playing the songs, and my band started playing their imitations of Russell Smith and J.W. Brown. By the second song, freaked him out. He'd turn around looking, okay, what's going on? I also spent a little time teaching them how to play songs they didn't know. And my guys knew it, so he started playing songs he hadn't recorded, and they played all those. So he hired us on the spot. I was on the road with him for 2 years off and on. I had a little birth injury. It kind of paralyzed me on my right side. It took me a year to learn how to hold a pick. That's no excuse, I know.
Do you think your illness as a child helped your, not helped, but influenced your music?
Oh, yeah. If I hadn't been crippled, I'd have been selling insurance. People got to remember or be aware of that in their life. You play the hand that you got. I know I sound like Mahatma Gandhi. I don't mean to.
Do you think you had the same attitude 40 years ago?
40 years ago?
Yeah, do you think you thought the same way 40 years ago?
Oh, no, I thought the world cheated me big time. And why did I have to have all this? And had people when I was playing, I took piano lessons for 10 years, and there's girls coming up taking piano lessons for 3 years, and they were playing in Carnegie Hall, and I was still trying to figure out how to play. My right hand was so messed up that I ended up figuring out stuff that I could play. So I guess that kind of contributed to writing in some way. And I'd play those sessions. We'd play tracks, we have chord sheets, so we'd play the tracks. Sometimes we'd play them 10 times before we ever heard the melody, heard the singer. Just out of boredom, I'd write songs to those tracks as it's going by. A lot of times I didn't like the other guy's song as well. 90% of the records that I did were bull. I mean, I didn't play on any Ray Charles records. Didn't play on any Mancini records. You know, I think some of the guys in the Wrecking Crew may have, but I didn't.
You played with Sinatra?
Yeah, one or two times. But there's so many policemen there that I made me nervous. I didn't want to go. He said he'd cut Song for You if I'd played the piano on it, but I don't know. I must have been 8 or 10 highway patrolmen at his sessions, and it scared the shit out of me.